Hello everybody, I am Rajesh Walalkar on behalf of TheFitnesity, and this program on the eve of World Health Day is being conducted in association with Corporation India in their boardroom. Those of you who have seen our previous videos are having an idea. We are having great interest in creating content driven towards health and fitness. Today's program on the eve of World Health Day is devoted to the theme devised by WHO. It's called Universal Health Coverage. And I have four expert panelists with me to discuss aspects of universal health coverage and how different issues could be addressed in their professional capacities. Over to my august panelists here.
So I'm Dr. Anjali Tarvalkar, MD DGO, practicing gynecology in this area, right from suburban to the corporate hospitals. Mainly working in the field of high risk pregnancies, but also teenage medicine is the want of the or the demand of the time. So I have been practicing teenage medicine also in this area. It happened so that we founded this Corporation India with a view of preventing cancer, especially cervical cancer, in women. So while making them more healthy, especially on this World Health Day, that we thought that let's promote good health by preventing all kind of cancers in women, because women are the important part of the society, and these are the cancers that would happen between 40 and 50 years of their age. So I welcome you to Corporation India, which is a holistic health studio, which will go with the theme of Mr. Rajesh Walalkar, as he said that it's a universal health for all.
Hello everyone, I'm Upama Mishra. I am a yoga teacher from the world-renowned Yoga Institute. My journey of yoga started 10 years back with a teacher's training certification. And now I'm also a certified Yoga Alliance teacher. I specialize in yoga for women, and I'm very happy today to be a part of this panel discussion on the occasion of World Health Day.
Hello everyone, I'm Naina Sindhania. I'm a clinical dietitian, diabetes educator, and a sports nutritionist. I am also one of the few registered dietitians of India. I've been working in this field for the past 5 years, and I have had the opportunity to work with a few of the reputed hospitals of Mumbai. For me, nutrition is all about being sustainable, and at the same time, it is also about being mindful and being balanced.
Hello friends, I'm Dr. Jyoti Maneshwari. I'm a psychiatrist and psychotherapist practicing in Andheri West, Lokhandwala, for the last 21 years. I help the people of all age to attain to the emotional stability through pharmacotherapy, psychotherapy, and past life therapy. My special interest is stress management, and I do conduct workshops for different corporate schools and all for the stress management, as well as also on the parenting. And I'm very happy to be here today on the occasion of World Health Day to share my views on mental health with you.
So, as we announced right in the beginning, we are going to work towards bringing about awareness on universal health coverage. Now, as we know, India is having one of the largest population of people below poverty level as measured by World Bank. So, access of health is a big issue in this country.
Now, on this background, I want panelists who are professional in their respective areas to address this question, how we could provide advices or services to people who are less privileged and who have less resources. For example, could dietitian come up with, you know, advice for people who do not have enough money or resources for survival?
Yes, definitely. With the experience that I've had with the people who could not afford even the basicest of medical services, a lot of them, for them, I would like to say that it is, you do not have to make it complicated. It needs to be as simple as your food availability, what is local and what is easily available. So when we talk about, let's take an example of when we talk about for a person who's suffering from, in let's say, a tuberculosis or a cancer, for those people we say that it's very important that a high protein diet is given to them. But at the same time, what happens is a lot of stress is laid on a high protein supplement. But again, for people who can't afford, examples like our very own pulses that are easily available. We, as individuals, as a commoner, we do not come to know that when it is combined with a cereal, the quality of protein that it gives is amazing. And that is one of the reasons why we say that khichdi is supposed to be a great staple food for people like us, because it combines, it complements, the cereal and a pulse complements it really well and gives you an amazing protein profile. So things like that, for example, a person who is probably suffering from iron deficiency, as simple as garden cress seeds, which is very easily available in a grocery shop, can be easily taken and has an amazing bioavailability. So what I am trying to say is the very simple and locally easily available ingredients can make a great difference, which are economical. The only thing that needs to be done is probably educate the mass in the right direction. That it is not always the money that will give you nutrition, but it can be as simple ingredient that will provide you the best of nutrition.
You know, the dietitian's role is started being played by mothers and the elders of the family. If they're not staying with them, then it's like over the phone, but all these things do start. So supervised dietitian or a diet supervised is a must. Now what happens is, now a lot of high risk pregnancies, people get married late, so various problems are there. So suddenly for a peanut sized baby of 2 months, you can't expect it to have 4 chapatis and increase your diet by 4-fold. So similarly, then, you know, that excess weight gain is something which we really need to stop. Similarly, there is a lot of awareness, let me tell you, in various sectors also about the exercise. The mother-in-law tells the daughter-in-law, "Arey, bhandi dhu, kapde dhua, he kara, te kara." You know, lot of things, lot of issues will happen. But then sometimes, first 3 months are the most coveted part of the, crucial part of the baby, where the organogenesis, or what we call it, the baby starts developing. That is the time the mother might require rest. So that is a time she may not really be advised to do any exercise. So, you know, again, the supervision part really becomes important, and every primary health sector or health organization, we do have, you know, a health system going to grassroots levels. So at all the points, mother and child health is really considered by government also. And they do have these supervised kind of doctors who are looking after it. So people, when they ask about prenatal yogas, and you know, the yoga during the phase of what I say, that antenatal yogas that we are also promoting, and we really want people to take it up, there is importance of supervising. And again, in pregnancy, there are certain hormones which are secreted called relaxin. And these are the hormones which will, you know, loosen your joints, because this is all mandatory, or it's a part and parcel of, you know, going through the pregnancy. So during that time, you have to have your physiotherapist or your yoga instructor or the person who is giving you instructions to do a particular task. That person needs to be properly educated and told, and that is where is the role of, when we go to grassroots levels, like how she can easily carry a mat and, you know, teach yoga to anybody and everybody. A dietitian can really give them the exact knowledge. I feel that whenever a person comes to us, let her husband be accompanied by her, let her in-laws and the people who are governing, you know, the household kitchen have to be accompanied. It's the holistic kind of approach that we always work on. It's a family medicine that we're practicing. So may you come from a most downtrodden family, or you're at the affluent family, let me tell you, the malnutrition is the same for all. And that is where we have to grow the new generation, the new buds, to come to a flowering end. We want to see the beauty of womanhood. So, you know, that is where it would start.
As far as yoga is concerned, I would like to add here that even in yoga, we say that, you know, we can practice yoga by making certain very small changes in the daily things that we do or in our lifestyle. So this is what we can teach people, how to bring about those little changes in the daily things that we do. For example, I would say, like we were talking about diet. So what we can eat and when we can eat, how much can we eat, we can cover that part as far as yoga is concerned. And we can also tell them that eating what can induce what kind of a mind that one is looking for. For example, if you're looking for the calmness of the mind, what type of food should be eaten so that you can have that state of mind? Or we can also tell them about how they should do their daily things so that they get the required movement of the body, right? For example, we talk about exercise, right? Or we talk about asanas. And as he told us that we are actually trying to educate the people who are at the base level. So the common man, we can just tell them how doing the daily activities, how by doing just those daily activities, one can achieve a healthy lifestyle. For example, I would say in yoga, we pay a lot of attention on the spine, right? So how doing the five basic movements of the spine every day, we can attain a certain level of health.